attitudes in the music industry of people, you know, the producers and stuff, have changed and become more favorable to women?
I think producers have always been pretty favorable towards women. It was mainly radio and I think promoters. And yeah, I think the Fair really did change the perceptions of that.
Which changed it?
Lilith Fair.
Lilith Fair.
Yeah,
okay.
The woman's tour.
Yeah, so it accomplished what it set out to do.
I think so. I'm not sure what exactly Sarah was hoping to accomplish exactly, but
would you say that if a record makes a lot of money, that also causes producers and radio stations to kind of pay attention and all reservations disappear?
Yeah. I mean, when I first came out, though, if there were more than three women on the radio station, the fourth couldn't get played, yet there were 20 guys being played. There were a lot of, you know, limitations, but it's not as bad as when Joni Mitchell was touring and Ella Fitzgerald and Billie Holiday were touring, and Joni, you know, that was different.
Let me display my ignorance by asking you what the Lilith Fair is.
Ah, that is good. Lilith Fair was a tour that Sarah McLachlan set up of all women. It was kind of controversial because it was exclusive, of course.
Mm-hmm.
But promoters weren't giving women as much money and things like that, so it did sort of change the misconceptions of women having a draw. And
is stuff. The money that you are paid for personal appearances equal to that for a male star of your stature?
Yeah, I think it was just mainly promoters were afraid we couldn't sell out the same size venues. We weren't as big as stars. We wouldn't have the same draw power when we turn out to have more.
And when you play a venue, what's the average crowd that's there?
It depends what kind of show I'm doing. I love theaters. I'd rather do a couple nights in a theater in a row. But, you know, doing big places is fun, too.
Kim, I'm glad you called, and thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Jewel. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Well, Kim, you don't look so bad yourself.
I know.
Thanks for calling me.
I know.
Bye-bye.
And to Alicia in Trevose, Pennsylvania, outside of Philadelphia. Hi, Alicia. How are you?
I'm doing fine, Tom. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. What's on your mind, young lady?
Jewel, I have a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Aside from absolutely admiring you, and I must say I'm so grateful that you did not do anything about your tooth when you and Rosie had talked about that on the show. I think that's so wonderful. But my question is, if you could have one wish that could make a change in this world, what would you make it?
Puppies for all children.
I'm for that. I'm for that.
I don't know. I'm not good at questions like that. I guess thoughtfulness is always good.
You know, Alicia, I'll turn your question back to you. What would your answer be to that question?
Okay, the answer to what? Wow, I didn't expect you to put me on the spot, but in all seriousness...
Well, you put Jewel on the spot, Alicia.
Yeah,
I put you on the spot.
Yeah, the idea of, for me, if I could have one wish come true, that would be it, when people talk about race...
Mm-hmm.
To me, there is only one race, and that's the human race.
Absolutely.
I agree.
Be the answer.
Alicia, have a great holiday season. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
We're coming right back, and Jewel will sing a song. Only she knows the title, but it will be revealed after these messages. Now with a number from the new CD, which is called Spirit, here is our new best friend, Jewel.
Inside my skin, there is this space. It twists and turns. It bleeds and aches. Inside my heart, there's an empty room. It's waiting for lightning. It's waiting for you. that soul is haunted. It creaks and moans. My bones call to you in their separate skin. I make myself translucent to let you
That is Jewel from the new CD, which is called Spirit. Jewel, we thank you for joining us. Have a Merry Christmas. Back with Georgia Durante and her amazing story after this short break.